one more job shouldn't have mattered. I'd killed nobles before. You could float a whaling ship on the highborn blood I've spilled. Another noble steps in to replace the last one. All equally corrupt. Why should an empress be different? But she was. I watched her bodyguard's face as they took him away. Dead eyes. I knew I'd pay for this one. Maybe I deserved to. A storm was coming that would shake apart everything I'd built.
Dowd, my old friend. It's been a long while, but you've got my interest again. How the years pass and the bodies fall. Did you know that there are only 8 like you in the world, bearing my mark? I'm here because you're right. The Empress was different. This time, you can't just fade away into the shadows. There will be consequences. Your story is... Even you can't escape it. But what ending will you make for yourself? I'm here to give you one last gift, Dowd. It's a mystery. One that starts with a name. Delilah.
For 6 months, the city writhed and changed. For 6 months, I tried to forget what I'd done to the Empress and her little girl. But there was no forgetting. I needed to find my next move. But all I had was that name. Delilah. Who was she? A threat? Oh, an ally? Word came from my second-in-command, Billy Lurk. In a house built on secrets. Lurk was especially good at uncovering them. There was a ship called the Delilah. It hunted whales for Bundry Rothwild. A former deckhand who'd made good. Now he owned a slaughterhouse and he ran his workers like a prison gang. A ship named Delilah. It could be a coincidence. But it's not. In Dunwall, things are always tangled up like a bag of snakes.
You're here. I got bored, so I started without you. Turns out we're here on the perfect day. There's a strike at the plant, and it's no wonder. Rothwild runs this place like a prison. The stupid workers can't even get in without a time card. When the strike started, the butchers confiscated all the cards they could find. They've given the City Watch free rein to use force. If you ever wondered why I wanted out of the slums, here's your answer. There'll be other ways in, I'm sure of it. You don't mind if I tag along, right? Just to keep an old man safe. One last thing. I found something for you. I know you collect these. I'll be on the rooftops till you need me.
You have to give me back my time card. I can't get back in. You had no right to take it.
Try and get past me, and I'll see you swinging from a meat hook.
Go home, mister. Orders are to confiscate those cards. No exceptions. What?
Guards, to me!
I guess.
Assassin! Get behind him! We're not taking this one alive! Someone get over here! Die!
Oh, God. I'll cut you to pieces!
Butcher! Get over here!
Attention. Under plague conditions, failure to report for...
There's a man out on the river watching the place. If I weren't so young and pure of heart, I'd suggest he's up to no good. Stories about a woman in the slums who did work like this. Granny Rags. They said she was 100 years old.
Seen on the slaughterhouse grounds. He is to be captured or killed on sight. We have the full compliance of the law and the city.
And you'll be back at work tomorrow.
The overseers will be starting up services again soon.
Thank you.
of it passed me by. All the others down with the sickness.
They won't let you in without a time card. But if you get us out of here, you can take mine. I'm not coming back.
I already have a time card.
Oh. I guess you got no real reason to help us then. We still need to get past that wall of light contraption they put up. If you can shut it off, we can slip past the city watch when the time is right.
All these rats crawling all over everything.
Is the wall of light down?
You're free to go. Make your way out of this place.
Thank you. Guess you took what you came for. Just, if you see Abigail Ames, tell her we still believe in her.
Asking nicely is going to work. We'll have to find a more persuasive means of getting what you want out of him. He's probably close to his office. We should start there.
Hey, have you been in the chair already?
Yes, but I signed right away. Mr. Rothwell didn't even have to turn it on.
I don't believe you.
No, it's true.
Is he calling you a liar?
That's what it sounds like. I'm gonna teach you to respect me. That went a little deep. It was only supposed to scare him. Oops.
Well, he did look scared. Just at the end there.
Break's over.
When's this day gonna end?
Your men, you'll collect your bonuses at sundown in my offices. Well done, my boys. The rest of you piss off.
What do those idiots want, anyway?
Well, they think they don't get treated fairly. Because they can get fired for refusing to do dangerous work.
What? We're the ones that do the dirty stuff around here. Maybe we need to be organizing, huh?
Hey, that's not funny. You say that again, even as a joke, and you're way over.
Yeah, sure. You just say it.
Stop listening in on that Abigail Lane's tricky talk. She'll cry.
I'll be glad when we get the order to get rid of her. It's only a matter of time.
Think this crap with the strike will blow over soon?
No way. I won't find you. Every man should have to work a little. Don't you think? When I find you, I'm gonna kill you. You'll be slinking out in your belly like a worm. Wake up, my old uncle. Think I won't find you? Every man should have to work with it. Don't you think?
Striking laborers, my generous offer stands. Half pay in a dozen lashes. By now.
Ramsay? No, this is about the workers. Is anyone there? I know. Well, Dowd, what do you want with me?
I'm not here for you. I'm here to learn about a ship called the Delilah.
Did the Lord Regent send you? That old fool, Hiram Burrows. I know all about the Delilah. All of it. And I can give you exactly what you want.
Please do.
Not so fast. I need something from you in exchange.
That's what I thought. What?
We're both professionals, Mr. Dowd. I was hired to get these gutless workers striking, which I did very nicely. And then destroy the slaughterhouse itself. That's where I got caught. And that's where I need your help.
How?
The whale oil in those tanks out there is enough to destroy this entire place. The important industrial bits, especially. Just open all the valves at once to let the oil start flowing. The pressure will go out of control, and... boom.
What about the people inside?
Growing a conscience? The factory workers are already out. My boss will hire them on, in better conditions than they'd ever see here. Not the butchers, though. They can die screaming for all I care.
Don't try and con me.
Wouldn't dream of it. Here's the key. Don't get caught. You take care of the slaughterhouse, and I'll tell you everything I know about the Delilah.
Tonight.
Shut your blowhole, get back to work.
I'm afraid Mr. Rothwild's no longer with us.
Thank you.
power system in there looks like it will put down that whale in an instant. I almost think you should. I know they're just beasts, but still. I spotted a makeshift interrogation room in the meat locker. It might be useful to you, considering our mission here.
You can be chosen if you come out.
Sailing in murky waters, assassin. Now, they say that ship was sold to Rothwild cheap by one of his business partners, a barrister, Arnold Tinch. They plan to sell a portion of the whale oil on the black market, instead of giving it to the Lord Regent. Treason. Would that be why you're here?
My reasons are my own. The black market doesn't concern me.
Interesting. Because that's only half the story. Arnold Timps sold that ship to Rothwild because he was afraid of its namesake. Timps fell in love with a painter named Delilah. It was the scandal of the season. That shrunken old lecher acting like a giddy schoolboy over a nobody. A former serving girl from Dunwall Top.
Let me guess. It didn't end well.
It never does. But there's a mystery to this one. Something happened that frightened him very much. He dropped her overnight and sold the ship for a quarter of what it's worth. And Barrister Tinch is not a man who scares easy. If you want to know more, you'll have to ask him yourself. But I very much doubt he'll tell you.
I guess we're done here. I'll meet you outside.
shrines. Tell me about the blood ritual.
What's going on? Go to me! You're gonna bleed, damn you! Watch out! Die, idiot!
I'm worried they sent for the hounds.
Run. You valued your lives at all. Run.
Is anything bothering you, Dad? I've seen you kill a man without ruffling his hair. You took out the whole neighborhood. Barrister Timsh lives up in the legal district. I know it pretty well. From what I hear, the Timsh family is practically at war with itself. Talk to his niece Tali if you can. I should probably tag along when you go. Crazy rich people are buying up a lot of that Sokolov security technology these days. Keeps the weepers and looters out. I might be useful.
Let's go.